Not by so much you, Montague. But I bite myself, Montague.
Do you quarrel, Montague?
Quarrel, Capulet?
No,
Capulet. Drop you even! Gregory, remember my slashing blow!
Hard fools!
Put up your swords. You know not what you do.
What are those drawn among these heartless hinds?
Tell me, Benvolio. Look upon thy death.
I do but keep the peace. Build thy sword, or manage to part these men with me.
What, drawn in talk of peace? I hate that word as I hate hell. All Montagues and thee, have at thee, coward!
What noise is this?
Thou villain Capulet! Hold me not, let me go!
Thou shalt not stir a place to seek a foe.
What call you, beast? You ever stir our streets again? Your life shall pay, forfeit the peace.
Who set the ancient quarrel you abroach? Speak now, nephew, will you buy what have begun?
Here were the servants, your adversary, and here's close fighting. Here, I did approach.
Oh, where's Romeo? Striking him today? Right glad I am he was not at this fray.
Early walking did I see your son, tears augmenting the fresh morning dew. My noble uncle, do you know the cause?
I don't know, nor can I learn.
Could we but learn from whence his sorrows grow, we would as willingly give cure as know.
See where he comes, so please you step aside. I'll learn his grievance or be much denied.
Come on, madam. Let's away.
Goodbye, president.
Day so young,
but you struck nine.
Ah, me, sad hours seem so long.
What sadness lengthens Romeo's hours?
Not having that, which having makes them short.
In love?
Out.
Of love?
Your favor, where I am in love.
Tell me, sadness cousin, who is this you love?
And sadness cousin, I do love a woman.
I am so good and I assumed you loved.
A right fair monk, man, and she's fair I love.
A right fair mark, fair cuz, is soonest hit. Be ruled by me, I forget to think of her.
Oh, teach me how I should forget to think.
My ubiquity until thine eyes, examine other beauties.
Farewell, thou canst not teach me to forget.
I'll pay that doctor or else die in debt.
What say, my lord, what send you to my suit?
My child is yet a stranger in this world. She hath not been changed her fortune years. Let two more summers wither and deprive, ere you may think her ripe to be a bride.
Yonder is she, our happy mother's name.
And too soon there are those her early made. Her wooers and prepares, get her heart. My will to her consent is but a part. Tonight I hold an old accustomed feast, whereto I have invited many a guest. Go towards about to fair Verona, and find those persons out whose names are written there, and to them say, my house is welcome on their pleasure stay.
Find them out whose names are written here.
I must learn in good time.
I pray, sir, can you read?
Aye, my nose looking in my misery.
Signor Martino and his wife and daughters. My uncle Capulet and my niece Rosaline. Signor Valentino and his cousin Tybalt. A fair assembly, hither should they come.
Supper to our houses.
To whose house?
My master is the carriage, Capulet. And if you be not of the house of
Montague,
then I pray, come and craft a cup of wine. Rest you merry. At this same ancient feast of Capulets, suits the fair Rosaline is now so. Go hither with untinted eyes, examine some beauties that I shall show, and I will make thee think a slaughter crow.
One fairer than my love? The all-seeing sun you saw match was first the world begun. I'll go along, no such sight to be shown, a dear person splendor of mine own.
Thank you.
dream not of.
Well, think of it now. The valley of Paris seeks you for his love. A man, young lady. Lady, such a man is all the world. Why, he's a man of wax. What say you? Can you love the gentleman? Tonight, we shall behold him at our feast. Speak briefly. Can you like of Paris's love?
I'll look to like, if looking liking move.
Madam, the guests are come. We follow thee.
Go, girl, seek happy nights to happy days.
Gentle Romeo, we must have you on the dance floor.
Thank you. Can I go forward when my heart is here?
Romeo! My cousin! Romeo!
Ah! He's alive. All my life has stolen from home to bed.
Call for Mercutio! Romeo!
You
were... Mother!
Passion? Lover? I conjure thee by Rosalie's bright eyes.
If thou shalt hear thee, thou wilt anger him?
This cannot anger him. My invocation is fair and honest. And in his mistress' name, I conjure only but to raise up.
Come, he hath hid among the trees. Blind is his love. Best benefits the dark.
If love be blind, love cannot hit the mark.
Romeo!
Good night.
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise for a second, kill the envious moon. It is my lady, oh, it is my love.
Ay me.
She speaks. Oh, speak again, bright angel.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo. Wherefore art thou Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or, if thou wilt not, be but sworn my love, and I will no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak at this?
It is but thy name which is my enemy. Romeo, doff thy name. For that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word. Henceforth I never will be Romeo.
What man art thou thus bescreened in night, so stumblest on my counsel?
My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself, because it is an enemy to thee.
My ears have not yet drunk 100 words of that tongue's utterance. Yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo, and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
How camest thou hither? Tell me and wherefore. This place is death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
What love can do that dares love attempt? Therefore thy kinsmen are no let to me.
If they do see thee, they will murder thee.
Alack, there lies more peril in thine eyes than 20 of their swords.
I hear a noise within. Dear love, adieu. Anon, good nurse. Sweet Montague, be true. Stay but a little. I will come again.
Oh, blessed, blessed night. I am a fair. Being a knight, all this is but a dream.
Three words, dear Romeo, and good night indeed. If that thy bent of love be honorable, thy purpose marriage, send me word tomorrow. By when thou procure to come to thee, where and what time wilt thou perform the rite? I come anon, but if thou mayest not, well, I do beseech thee. By and by I come, to seize thy suit and lead me to my grief. Tomorrow will I send.
So pardon my soul.
1,000 times good night.
It's my soul that calls upon my name.
Romeo! I did forget why I called thee back.
And let me stand here till thou remember it.
Good night, good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night till it be morrow.
Sleep well upon thine eyes. Peace is our rest.
Thank you.
Where the devil should this Romeo be? Came he not home tonight?
Now to his father's. I spoke with his man.
Ah, that same pale, hard-hearted wench. That Rosaline torments him so, he will sure run mad. The old kinsman of Capulet has sent word to his father's house. A challenge on my life. Romeo will answer how he dares, being dared.
Alas, poor Romeo! He is already dead!
What? What is Sybil? More than the Prince of Cats, I can tell you.
Here comes Romeo!
Pardon for Mercutio, my business was great.
How art thou out of breath? When thou hast the breath to say to me that thou art out of breath. Let me be satisfied. Is it good or bad?
You have made a simple choice. You know not how to choose a man.
No. No. But all this I did know before. What says of our marriage? What of that?
Lord, how my head aches! Oh, my God! My God!
Church incorporates you in one. Give me my Romeo.
We are undone, lady! We are undone! Alas! Tybalt.
Oh, Tybalt, Tybalt, the best friend I had, that ever should I see thee dead.
What storm is this that blows so contrary? Is Romeo slaughtered, and is Tybalt dead? My dear loved cousin, and my dearer lord?
Tybalt is gone, and Romeo banished. Romeo that killed him, he is banished.
Oh God, did Romeo hand shed Tybalt's blood?
It did, alas the day, it did. Shame come to you, Romeo.
Blistered be thy tongue for such a wish. He was not born to shame. Oh, what a beast was I to chide at him.
Will you talk well of him that killed your cousin?
Shall I speak ill of him, which is my husband?
Try to your chamber. I'll find Romeo to comfort you.
Oh, find him. Give this ring to my true knight, and bid him come take his last farewell. Wilt thou be gone? It is not yet near day. It was the nightingale, and not the lark, that pierced the fearful hollow of thine ear.
It was the lark, the herald of the morn. I must be gone and live, or stay and die.
Yon daylight is not daylight, I know it. Therefore stay, thou needest not to be gone.
Let me be ta'en, let me be put to death. I am content so thou wilt have it so. Let's talk, it is not day.
It is, it is. My hands, be gone, away. Madam!
Nurse, your lady mother, the day is broke, be wary, look about.
Then window, let day in, and let life out.
Farewell, farewell.
Oh, thinkest thou we shall ever meet again?
I doubt it not, and all these woes shall serve to be sweet discourses in our time to come.
Daughter, are you up? Why, how now, Juliet?
Madam, I am not well.
Evermore weeping for your cousin's death? But now, I'll tell thee joyful tidings, girl.
And joy comes well in such a needy time. What are they? I beseech your ladyship.
Well, well, thou hast a careful father, child. One who, to put thee from thy heaviness, hath sorted out a sudden day of joy.
Madam, and happy time. What day is that?
Marry, my child, early next Thursday morn. The young, noble gentleman, the county Paris, at St. Peter's Church, shall make thee a happy bride.
I pray you, tell my lord and father, madam, that I will not marry yet. And when I do, I swear it shall be Romeo, whom you know I hate, rather than Paris. These are news indeed.
Here comes your father. Tell him so yourself, and see how he takes it at your hands.
What, still in tears? How now, wife? Have you delivered her our decree?
Aye, sir, but she will none. She gives you thanks. I was a fool when married to her day.
How? Will she none? Doth she not give us thanks? Is she not proud? Doth she not count her blessed?
How proud you have, but thankful that you have. Proud can I never be of what I hate, but thankful even for hate that is meant love.
How now, chalk logic? What is this? Thank me no thinking, nor proud me no proud. The fetter fine joint hangs Thursday next, with Paris of St. Peter's Church, or I will drag thee on a curb of thither.
Fie, fie, what, are you mad? Good father, I beseech you on my knees to speak a word.
Hate thee, young baggage, disobedient wretch. Speak not, reply not, do not answer me.
God in heaven bless her. You are to blame, my lord, to rank her so.
And why, my lady wisdom? Hold your tongue.
May not one speak?
Peace, you mumbling fool.
You are too hot.
God's bread, it makes me mad.
Oh, sweet my mother, cast me not away. Delay this marriage for a month, a week.
Do not talk to me, for I will not reply. Do as thou wilt, for I am done with thee.
Oh, God, how shall this be prevented? Some comfort. Damnation! O most wicked fiend! I'll to the friar to know her remedy, and if all else fails, myself have power to die.
On Thursday, sir, the time is very short.
My father Capulet will have it so, and I have nothing to slow slack his intake.
You say you do not know the lady's mind. Uneven is the course, I like it not.
She weeps her tool's death, therefore, we have little talk of love.
I would I knew why it should be slowed. Look, here comes the lady.
Happily met, my lady, and my wife.
That may be, sir, when I may be your wife.
Come you to make confession?
To answer that, I should confess to you.
Do not deny that you love me.
Are you at leisure, or shall I come to you at evening mass?
My leisure serves thee, pensive daughter, now. My lord, you must retrieve the time. Alone.
God shield thee, I should not disturb devotion. But for now, Juliet, on Thursday early. On Thursday early. I will rouse thee. Till then, adieu, and keep this word.
Juliet, I already know thy greeting.
Oh, friar, tell me. Thou hearest of this, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it.
Hold, daughter, I do spy a kind of hope. If, rather than to marry Paris, thou have the strength of will to save thyself, then is it likely thou wilt undertake a thing like death to chide away the shame? And, if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy.
Oh, bid me leave, rather than marry Paris, off the battlements of yonder tower.
Hold, then, go home, be married. Wednesday is tomorrow. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and this distilled liquor drink thou off. The roses in thy cheeks and lips shall fade, and in this barred likeness of drunk death, thou wilt continue for 2 and 40 hours. In the meantime, against thou shalt awake, Will Romeo by my word no other drift, and hither shall he come?
Give me, oh, tell me not a fear.
Hold then, get you gone, be strong and prosperous. In this resolve, I'll send word to thy lord.
Love give me strength, and strength shall help afford. Farewell.
What, is my daughter gone to Friar Lawrence?
Aye, forsooth.
Won't she make chance to do some good on her? A peevish self with harlotry it is.
See where she comes from, tricked with merry look.
How now, my headstrong? Where have you been gadding?
Where I have learned to repent of sin, disobedient opposition. So push straight here, and beg your pardon.
Send for the county, will tell him of this, I'll just not get up tomorrow morning.
And the fee is the lord at Friar Lawrence's.
A poor god is reverent holy friar, our whole city's what's bound to her.
Nurse, will you open me into my closet? To help me sort such needful ornaments, as you think it's furnished me tomorrow?
Go talk to Juliet. Help to decor up. Her heart is wondrous light, since the same wayward girl is so reclaimed.
Aye, this attire's at best. But gentle nurse, I pray thee, leave me to myself tonight.
Need you my help?
No, madam. So please you. Let me now be left alone, and let the nurse this night sit up with you. For I'm sure you have your hands full on in this so sudden business.
Good night. Get thee to bed, for thou hast me.
Farewell. God knows when we shall meet again. Come, vile. This mixture do not work at all. Shall I then be married tomorrow morning? No, this shall forbid it. Romeo, I come. This is to entering to thee. Juliet! God forgive me, how sound is she asleep? Anise must wake her.
Let me have a dram of poison such soup spitting gear that the life of
Undertaker may fall dead.
Such mortal drugs I have. But he who says that enters the law that will perfect the head.
Art thou so full of wretchedness and fear to die? Famine is in thy cheeks.
I will.
I pay thy poverty and not thy will. Farewell, buy food and get thyself in flesh. Come cordial, not poison. Go with me to Juliet's grave, for there must I use thee.
Unhappy fortune, the letter was not nice, but full of dear import, and the neglecting it made you much danger. Within 3 hours will fair Juliet wake. She will assure me much that Romeo hath had no notice of these accidents, but I will keep her with me until Romeo come.
Hope, take this letter. See that delivered to my lord and father.
I will be gone, sir, and not trouble you.
So stop, though shalt thou show me friendship. Take thou that. Live and be prosperous. Farewell, good fellow.
Doomsday.